You are here for one reason, so let's go directly to the content. Recently, I posted this and I received 400 likes. Isn't it cool? I have finished the templates that we are going to use to create amazing artwork. In this video, we are going to achieve 3 goals: how to use the templates, how to manage them, and how to create our own templates. And also, I reserve a surprise for the end. Just stay with me because there is a lot of things. Are you really ready? Because here we go. When we want to import templates in Krita, we need to use the resource folder. You will see that in a minute. We go to the settings, configure Krita. In the general section, we look for the resources stuff, and there you have it. Click here. And this is a trick that I use a lot. Look for the Krita folder, place Krita here, and I have everything available for modifications if I need it. So this is the folder that we are going to use. And now to use the templates is really easy. You just unzip this file and extract, copy to the folder, the Krita templates folder. There you have it. I use Krita 5.2.6. So if you find glitches, just go to this release, which works perfectly. Now you see how easy it is to use the templates in Krita. I click in new image. You can see how this new category has been created. If I may click here, you can see all the templates already available for you. You are free to explore all of them. You will discover a lot of interesting things. And what happens when you are using a template but you want to reset to default state? Is that even possible? Just let me show you. It's a good question. We are going to create an initial state. So let's create a new template. And once we have created the template, we're going to use the snapshot docker. It's located here in the snapshot docker. Press here and you have a snapshot. So now I can modify whatever I want, for example, the color. I have created a mess. Please help. So I select the snapshot and I click here and I restore everything in a second. Isn't it cool? Do you want to know how to get the best of these templates? I'm going to start to explain the paper group. I need to expand for options. And I can see that there are some layers that control the behavior. First one is this, the adjust texture. I press F3 or right click and look for properties, F3. And then I could change the texture if I want. Easy. The next one is the noise. It's used to make more grainy. And as you can see, this is changing visually, but in this case, I don't need so much. For the moment, I will leave at 25. The next one is the levels. I can control several things from this. Right click, go to properties, and you have the levels of the image. As you can see, I can control 3 different points that control the lightness, so I can make it lighter or darker. You get the idea. Also, you can see that there is some type of contrast in the texture. And to remove the contrast, I just go this direction towards to white, or go this direction towards to black, or I can use both and I can remove the contrast in the texture. If I click OK, you will see that there is not so much contrast as before. Ctrl C, see the result, and you can see there is more contrast. The next layer is for adjusting color. If I press F3, right click, or properties F3, I can select the color here. So I can use blue, green, purple, whatever you want for your image. And the last layer is just like an override of everything that controls this to change the hue. Or also, you can use the colorize option, but if the texture has a bit of color, you are removing to use only blues or only reds or only oranges tones. You decide, play the saturation. So if you don't want to deal with levels, color here, texture, you can use this one. It's the easiest way to modify the template, but not the most powerful. And why we use colored papers? Well, if I create a circle like this, just let me finish this in a minute, and reinforce the surrounding areas, you will see nothing. There is no painted area here. We have created a hole. But if we start to create shadow here, as you probably know, we are creating volume. And then I'm going to remove some parts to create a soft transition. I'm going to reinforce a bit this area, highlight, and boom, you have a sphere in 3D. But there is no pigment in all this area. So with this technique, we have dark tone, we have the paper, and then we have the light tone. And as you know, three tones produce volume. Let me show you this in a bigger example. So here you can see this portrait, and here you notice how this works. We can understand this basically as a big sphere. We have the shadow right here, and we have a highlight in this area. So basically the shadow is created with charcoal, and here there is no pigment at all, and there is only little points just to reinforce the volume effect with these lights. So as you can see, we reduce time shading our portraits or our scenes just using this technique, the colored paper that simulates the mid-tone or the halftone. Fantastic portrait, by the way. I love it. Thanks a lot, PGB, for your artwork and setting your portrait for this video. You can see more portraits, really interesting ones. Check it out. If you are thinking how much time you can save using this technique, here you have an example. If I remove the paper, you can see whiteness that the background provides. I can just put this into green and you will see the difference. That means all these areas are transparent. So if we deactivate this layer, these are all the areas that you haven't painted. You can see there is no shading here, no shading, just a bit, no shading. Amazing. And here you can see how different it looks when it doesn't have grain and the grain is integrated like paper, like I did in the charcoal KA video. Thanks a lot to DigiPaint for sharing his artwork for this video, and you can check it out his channel and amazing portraits and digital painting with Krita. And now let me know, are you enjoying this video? If so, please let me know in the comments. This group is in normal mode, and you can see that the opaque black part doesn't have texture. If you want to change that to get more realistic behavior, go here and select multiply. And now you can see how this has the paper behavior in transparent way as the mid-tones. Very useful if you want to create this type of shading. By the way, this template is the rough template. Now let me show you a very interesting trick. Imagine you want to see this artwork like if it was framed. So I copy and then I create a new template called Special Frame Pastel. I paste Ctrl B. I just go here to the transform tool and press Shift to constrain the ratio and make sure that the signature is inside. So now I rescale, press Enter, and there you have it, your frame picture. The good thing about this is that we can remove the frame line. We can remove the shadow also, create here. And we control the shadow with the layer style. With the drop shadow, we can control all the parameters that we want for the shadow. The good thing about this is that we can colorize the frame. Go to this layer to change the frame color, press F3 or right-click on properties, and you can see I can change the saturation, and suddenly the color appears, And this is frame with warm colors. But maybe you like it cold colors and you can't visualize the effect in real time. Just enjoy it. And how can I create my own template? Go to new image, select a new DNA4 horizontal, create it, and I have this layer, Control G, create the artwork. As you can see, I can colorize my groups. With right click, I select green and I remove the color from the layer, and you have this ready. I create a fill layer with a pattern, just the basic one, this one, and just Control G, and this will be the paper. I will remove this and I'm going to duplicate this and take out of the group, just F3, go here to the color and select this preset, white, FFF, okay, and the fill layer with the pattern. I'm going to remove this, and there you have it, paper. It's the final state. I select the layer that I'm going to use as we create the template. I go to the file, create a template from image. So I'm going to create a template from this, and this is a preview, but I could use a custom image. If you want to do that, I will recommend just to go here and select an area, cropping it like this. Now save as or export, just paper test, save, Control C. I have my paper again, and I go to file, create template from image, and go to custom. I select some paper test, and here I can create a new group. Let's make a new group like test. And there inside the test new group, I call my paper, paper 01, and done. I click OK and remove this file and create a new one. And in this case, I have a new group called test, and I can use paper 01. So use this template, and done. Have your paper. Where is located this? If you go to create a folder, you can see that in templates, you have a new category called test that has the file for the template, the source that is a document that we previously created, and the icon that we have used for the template. Easy, isn't it? So now you know how to create your own templates. And this is the surprise. You will get special surfaces, more patterns for your daily work, and more textures for texturing effects. They are DNA3 and seamless. And I'm considering to give the community a special bundle which contains brushes for digital look and speed painting purposes. So now is your turn. Subscribe if you find this useful. And let me know in the comments what part of the video you have enjoyed more. Remember, you have the link in the description. Download the content and there you have it. The templates are ready for you. They are free and you can use them for whatever you want. Do it commercially, do it for fun, just share with your friends, do whatever you want. We are very near to getting close 100,000 subscribers. Amazing. Thanks a lot, community. Remember, you have more content in the channel, so check it out and enjoy it. There are a lot of brushes in these videos. If you like pencils, this one is perfect for you. And if you like the crayons, this is also really cool. And the charcoal that is located here, Charcoal KA, one of the best bundles I have created. And this, which contains modifications from the default one that can create interesting variations. And if you want to know more about Smart Canvas, this is the video. So check it out and enjoy. See you right now in the next video.